Hello, everybody. So welcome to the first installment of Show Choir Thursday. I'm Gavin Ray.
I'm Mitchell Urban.
So we are going to get started. So, Show Choir Thursday. So it's a show choir. That's the CEO wants us to do show choir on Thursday. So before we start, we're going to get into Mitchell in a minute. So this is going to be fun. So before we start, remember, we have our musicians list arts auditions on the Instagram is the information, so just go follow at musicians list to get the information. There's updated information about like audition signups and like when the material will be sent out. It depends on our composer and when he finishes his piece. So the first piece we have today is Brandon Brio, or Brio, however they pronounce it, 2019. We won't really say themes and the show names for these shows, since it's very hard to pick this stuff out, especially when it's not as open as like a Bands of America or a Drum Corps International is. So we'll just do Brandon Brio 2019. So I'm going to start off with some questions for Mitchell. So Mitchell, this is your first ever time judging any sort of choir, especially a show choir. Are you excited?
I mean, I'm kind of nervous because this is throwing me out of my element. You know, orchestras, I can handle because I was in orchestra. Concert band, no problem. DCI, DOA bands, no problem. Jazz band even, perfectly fine. But choir, this is a whole new plan for me right here. I'm excited, but I'm just a little nervous.
But like this is exactly what our organization's about, connecting all arts one step at a time. This is going to connect you to the choir aspect of the arts. And just so specifically the show choir aspect of these arts, because we'll probably do some choir pieces on Sit Down Wednesday or Fun Time Sundays eventually. So choir judging, and I'll talk to you about how we'll judge this a little bit, but choir judging and band judging is very similar in the aspects of music and visual and general effect, but we call it the overall presentation in show choir. So what do you want to hear from the vocalist personally?
Well, I mean, I want to hear confidence in what they're doing, because, you know, the first step in anything in like performing is confidence, in any art, you know, band, orchestra, choir even, you know, it needs to be confident, it needs to be powerful, it needs to be strong. You have to have faith in what you're doing. So, I mean, I think it just all goes back to the confidence, and I think that's what really makes or breaks it from what show choir, what little show choir I've seen.
So, a show choir is sort of just like a indoor marching band on risers, I guess, but with the voices. And like, we will be reviewing the cadets tomorrow and how they have vocalists in their show and they even march. So that will be very interesting to see. But show choir, it's the art of singing and dancing. So I have one more question for you. Have you ever thought in your musical career that you would ever get to judge a show choir, or have you ever thought about joining a choir?
Well, for the first question, absolutely not. I would have never thought before taking this position as a host on the podcast that I would ever venture this far away from band land. and let's just say, you know, whenever Mr. Pope or any of our directors has us sing, you know, I'm not the prettiest voice out there, so to answer the second question, I would probably flop at it.
Oh, but do you know if you're like a tenor, baritone, or bass?
I don't know.
I feel like you might be a baritone, because I'm a tenor, so my voice is a lot higher. I think you might be a baritone or a bass, like bass one.
Really? Interesting.
Yeah. But like how choir does it, bass two goes lower. So it's like, it's weird. It's how it's set up. I view it as weird.
It's pretty self-explanatory.
So I will let you ask me some questions now.
So you're in a show choir at Tarpon. How does the size of the show choir affect the sound? I feel like this is pretty self-explanatory again, but I don't know.
Well, sort of, okay, so I'm going to also talk about the band real quick. So Tarpon Band, we are a small fish in a big pond at Grand Nats. And you guys know that. We're a 2A band that performs very well at a high level. And
you just round my question just right back at me.
Yeah, rounded your question. So a show choir is just the same. It's the it matters about how much effort and energy your choir members put into it, your vocalists. Like, I know personally, we only had 2 tenors in our show choir this year. We killed it. We had this part in Dies Irae that was like, Quan, Tus Quan, and it goes all the way up. We blasted that thing out, and Cheeseman was like, you know, good job. So it was like, bigger show choirs obviously have a bigger presence, but if a little show choir has the energy and the passion, they can definitely reach that level.
So basically David and Goliath.
David and Goliath, yeah. We're always a small fish in a big pond.
I pulled that one out specifically for you.
That's our show choir.
How does the choirs do relate to marching band and drum corps choreography?
So, some choreographers actually do both show choir and marching band, but with marching band, you do a lot of like swaying movement with the upper body or like stuff with your upper body, and you usually just use your legs to move. It's like just your lower body is like you're moving. What's the thing that they said in the and for you for Carmel? What's that analogy? Like the upper body is like the musician or artist, and then the
upper body's the musician, lower body's the athlete.
Yeah, so it's sort of like that, but not really for show choir. Show choir, we move everything. We move our arms like this while we're singing. We move our faces and we do facials. So facials are another form of our choreography that marching bands and drum corps usually try to use because, you know, just to sell the show that they're performing just like a show choir does. Right. So it's just, you know, it's similar but very different at the same time.
Intriguing. What do you want to hear from this group as a vocalist yourself? Like, what are you looking for?
So a vocalist should always have a very round sound. And when you're up in that register, it's like Cheeseman says stuff about like head voice. It should be up here. Like, it should sound like you're yawning. It should sound like a yawn, but when you yawn, it opens up your throat. So you sound deeper and you sound more full like this. So it should like open up the sound. And I want to hear just a full ensemble blend of all the voice parts, soprano, alto, tenor, and bass.
That kind of reminds me of what we do at Cromwell. Like, that's what Mr. Pope really pushes for. He wants to have like our open throat. He wants to just have a big, confident singing voice whenever we sing, which we do a lot of. Sometimes it gets annoying, but you know, it helps out a lot. So
it does. Like, you see a lot of drum corps that perform very well singing their stuff, like Blue Coats. I think it was their 2018 ballad, or just their any ballad. They sing their ballads. It sounds like a really great vocal choir. It sounds great, and that's another reason why they perform very well, because when you sing you have to nail those pitches, and that helps you with your instrument with those pitches as well. Okay,
I mean, that makes sense.
Yeah, so like, it's all very similar, but it's obviously different because it's vocal and you don't have an instrument to your face. This is our instrument. Our throat is our instrument with our mouth. So
okay,
well, we're going to split into separate calls, and we're going to judge. There's no separate categories. It's just a judge sheet with vocal, movement, and visual, and overall presentation. And we'll be right back with the judge papers.
Christopher Brewer and Dan Connick. Last year, Brio received Brandon.
That's a little loud. Okay, so hello, everybody. I'm Gavin Ray. This is my tape for Brandon Brio, 2019.
At the Grove Magnolia Invitational. This season,
turn that down a little bit. Yeah, so, yeah, we're going to get this started. I love judging show choirs personally. Our choir director has us do it sometimes for grade during this pandemic. He's had us do it for 4 weeks, so I'm sort of experienced with it a little bit, but not a professional. I love judging show choirs. It's a very fun thing to do for me personally.
And the joy of Christmas and the excitement of a new year. With sound technician Simone Keelan, tech director Manny Browning, and band director Drew Crenshaw, and assistant director Rachel Dennis, under the direction of Charlie and Lauren Hoover, please welcome to the stage, Brandon High School Brio!
Okay, here we go. Ooh. Oh, I love the costumes already. Very nice costumes.
Oh,
Nice song. I like the costumes. I love the just when they're all in tuxes and in like suspenders and dresses. It looks very nice. Oh, the background screens are cool too. Oh yeah, let's get it, guys. I have some diction issues here. There's a little bit of like diction problems. Could be just where the mic is. They sound great. Their overall vocal quality is very like it's executed at a high level, I should say. The choreography looks great. They seem all into it. I can definitely see the spatials. Ooh, okay. Little girl feature there. There's some like set problems, I think, right here. Just with those diagonals, I think they're supposed to be. They look like they should. Their overall sets are good, but I think just those diagonals there. Nice balance between the band and choir. Nice crescendo, guys. A nice use of dynamics. Okay, first song's over. Let the audience applaud then. Oh, St. Patrick's Day, okay. The band could have been a little louder there, but. Oh, they're all with top hats and green bow ties. Some movement there. We gotta make sure that stage professionalism is right on there. Nice choreography there. Obviously some moves can be cleaned, but they have a nice blend of parts. All the girls are out here. Nice use of the umbrellas. I like that. Thank you. how they're opening and closing them. That's cool. That's a nice use. Band sounds unsure sometimes. Don't over, like, do that. Nice costume changes. I love the costume changes. It fits the background. Nice dynamics. Very intense. It's a good thing. Very sharp moves. I do enjoy the pace of the show. It doesn't seem too fast and it doesn't seem too slow for my liking. There's nice pauses when they should have them. Especially in between the songs. Someone's way overemphasizing that. Personally, I don't need to hear America. That's way overemphasized. I don't know. I think it was just one person in my opinion, but oh, nice job, guys. Nice blend. I could hear all the voice parts there. You guys sound amazing, and you guys look great. Happy Halloween. that guy's funny. Nice job, solos. Building that tension for the choir. He sounds great. I just got chills. Very nice tension. Man knows when to play up. Nice guys. Nice change. Very intense costume. Everybody makes you drink or choose. Here's the night, right? It's our town. Everybody's drinking in this town of Halloween. Those are very clean, actually. A little bit of an effect there. This reminds me of the song we did this year, Emperor's New Clothes. It's very sharp and creepy, like, and just angry. That guy's going all out. He has some intensity there. Thriller. Overall, of the those transitions seemed a little frantic. Like towards the beginning, I know in the Halloween section was a turkey. Okay, well, in the Halloween section, those probably are supposed to seem frantic. But then sometimes in other places, when they transition from set to set, it just looks a little frantic at times. And I get the stress of trying to transition. It's pretty rough. I saw somebody trip. Oh, I feel so bad. You guys have great musicality. Sitting here and enjoying this. They sing so well. They have so many, like, costume changes that are impressive to me. I'm gonna change as fast as I do, multiple times. Nice backup sound. And the bells are ringing like a choir singing. In my heart I hear them, peace on earth, man. Beautiful. Oh, guys, you sounded great.
The apple falls in time, sing along with all the time. face. Tomorrow morning when we wake, sun will be a different place. And I will watch the way I understand. We will be in the kings of the world, on top of the nation. It's a celebration of the moments to come.
Nice blend of the costumes. Bunch of holidays. I like that theme. I've gotten so many chills while watching this group. It's just many chills have gone down my spine. They perform so well. Such a great show choir. Oh, tenors, yeah. Bows. There we go. Good bow. Nice bows. Great job, guys. Very entertaining to watch. I always love judging show choirs because it's just a great experience, you know? Well, great job, and I'm going to send you over to Mitchell State. All right. Hey, everybody. This is Mitchell for Musicians to the Stars podcast. So today we're going to be reviewing Brandon Brio 2020, the show choir. So obviously this is my first time, so cut me a break. I promise it'll be better next week. There's nowhere else to go but up from here. I'm looking forward to hearing this because from what I've heard from show choir, from my personal or top show choir, Carmel the Ambassadors, I've heard that they are outstanding, and all overall the choir program is outstanding. They have a really big holiday spectacular is what they call it, for the entire community. It's one of the high points of the entire community in Carmel. So, I'm looking forward to seeing what this group does, and fingers crossed, I won't totally just flub the judging. So without further ado, let's get into it.
Last year, Brio received Grand Champion at the Grove Magnolia Invitational. This season, Brio will be competing at the Jackson Academy Show Choir Invitational.
All right.
And Connecticut today to celebrate the year with sound technician Simone Phelan, tech director Mandy Brownley, with a charm.
Awesome. All right, here we go. Well, it seems really balanced to start out, personally, I think. Huh. I think the movement's pretty cool. I think the choreography so far has been pretty fun and interesting. I think the alto and soprano voices, which are majority female, I would assume,
I think they're really, overall, they're just balanced. I think they're doing a really good job of balancing each voice to each other. And they're all really in coordination with each other, and visually. So, I like the show band behind them. Yeah, I really think the lines, like the spacing in between each, is really, I think it's really solid so far. Nice little opening part of the show, so. It seems like it's all about various holidays, because I think there was a Valentine's Day, St. Patrick's Day. There's probably a Irish song, Celtic chant with the male singers. I think that's pretty cool how they feature. I like the choreography. They're really in it. They're really timing. I can see the emotion. I can feel the vibes, just like the energy pulsing from there. Just even watching this, this is really interesting. And I think the band, personally for me, I think it's doing really well. Pace of show, I really like how the speed of the show is going. And the female choir members joined back in, or look like they're coming in. Okay, now it's an all-female group of the choir. And they switched to Easter. Interesting. I like the little feel of the music. It's okay. And 4th of July. Okay. Interesting. All right. Oh. Wow. Acrobatic kind of just, wow, what flexibility. They really hold themselves to a high standard, I think. I think they do it really well. And then the females come back in and dresses with red and white, and then you got the blue of the male suit. I really like how the band is playing accompaniment to the choir. I think they're doing a really good job of balancing from you got your voice to you got your brass and you got your band. I think that they're really listening, and the band is doing a great job of listening and adjusting their sound to that. And they transition really well from each different holiday. And I can really just feel the intensity. I can feel the vibe. I like the costumes. Those are cool. They fit for each holiday. They do a really good job of projecting. They know when to be quiet. They know their dynamics are really well. They know they know when to be quiet. They know when to put the gas on. You know, what's throwing me back, that American flag, throwing it back to Broken Arrow, I will always remember that, but that's, and they played America in their closing, and I really enjoyed it, good job. I really enjoy America, I really love hearing that being performed by certain ensembles. Musicality. I think they're really doing. Oh, Halloween. Oh boy. Spooky. Brilliant. Well done, soloist. She's killing it. Yeah, I really like the choreography for Halloween. I like the musicality. I like everything about this. This is cool. I really don't have, from this, unexperienced choir judge. I think this is cool. I like that saxophone lick. This is how we live. There you go. Michael Jackson, there we go. I knew it had to come out at some point. It was Michael Jackson. It was Halloween, of course. The three soloists, those are really cool. I they do a really good job of everything. The band is really playing. They're laying down a steady beat for these singers to go off of. And then there's a turkey. All right, well, let the turkey have his own little dance break, and, bye, turkey. Peace. Oh, the turkey comes back. Roles are reversed. And then we go to Christmas. Yeah, the choreography, they're all visually just, they're in step, they're in sync, they're in time with each other, and I think that's a very, very, very important part of any musical group. I also like their musical selections. I'm a big Michael Jackson fan, so I loved Thriller. I have a Holly Jolly Christmas. I like that one too. That's one of my favorite Christmas tunes. Oh wow. Okay, very, very good by this male soloist here. I like how the entire choir is playing background to him. They're adjusting themselves to him. And I think that's a very good skill to have in a musician, being able to adjust to a single player. Okay. Yeah, through the entire show, I really haven't heard many inconsistencies in balance or blend. I think that they're all killing it in that respect, in that retrospect. This is definitely cool. I found a new respect for these. Alright, this is another fast tempo, this is cool. I like how they're able to shift from various genres and just tones of the music, like different styles. That's the word I was looking for. With relative ease, it seems flawless. I like that. I like how they're able to adjust and just switch from different styles, just right on the bat, just boom, different style. And I haven't seen any energy letdowns at all this entire show. Like, from the beginning to now, they've been the same, just up-tempo, upbeat energy I could sense just the entire choir. I mean, trust me, I imagine they're tired as heck. But they're putting the pedal down. They're giving it all to the performance. And I really think they're serving in terms of what our percussion director said, serving the music. I really think that they're serving the show that they have. Brilliant. Good job. Oh, wow. They're not over? Oh, there it is. Wow. All right. Well, that is Brandon Brio 2020. Wow. I was impressed. That was cool. So thank you for listening to this. I will be back with the next choir. I don't remember off the top of my head. I'm still getting used to, I'm still trying to figure out all these choir names and everything. So I will be back. Thank you.
Okay, guys, welcome back. So we're going to talk about, it's going to be a very different than the other, podcasts we do. So instead of like us discussing our judge papers, what we'll do is I'll say my scores, he'll say his scores, and then we'll talk about like vocal, movement, and overall presentation. So for vocal, I gave them an 86. Movement and visual, I gave them a 76. And overall presentation, I gave them a 68. And in total, out of 240, I gave them 230. So Mitchell, you can say your scores now.
So being the inexperienced show choir judge that I am, I was probably a little bit generous, but I gave them a 90 on vocals, 80 on movement and visual, and then a 69 on overall presentation. So that'd be a grand total of 239.
I mean, for your first, I mean, you got the right point range.
It was in there.
So I want you to tell me like how you felt about the vocals. How do you think they sounded?
I think they sounded spot on.
I
think it was good. I think it was, for me at least.
Well, I mean, I agree. They're always a very great show choir to watch, but there were some points where like the sopranos would oversing it, or the altos wouldn't be there as much as they could have been. Same with the tenors. And then just some intonation problems like you would probably have in a brass ensemble or woodwind ensemble. Just like little nitpicky things I usually pick out when I listen to it, because show choirs can sound spot on, but then you got to dive in there. You got to just slip your hand in there and pick out what you can find. And honestly, our scores were very close, and I would agree. Like, if I was inexperienced, I would have given them a 90 straight on, because they're a great group. So we'll move on to visual and movement. So how do you think that, how was that? How was the movement for you?
I think it was really, I think they had a certain composure, identity. And I think they maintained that the entire time. Like, you know, I personally, because what I was thinking was confidence, what I said earlier in the podcast. I was looking for like people who were being confident in what they could do and everything along those lines. I think they did that pretty darn well. I really didn't have much issues. I think the blocking and spacing, personally, I think that was their best. They handled transitions from each holiday pretty darn well. Choreography was pretty interesting to watch. Intensity, they were just spot on. They all bought in. They handled themselves really professionally, and that's what I was talking about with the confidence along those lines. And then the physical appearance, you know, I'm sure they were gassed, but they gave it 110% the entire 20-minute set. And then costuming, I think that was pretty good. I think that was pretty good with what they, for the theme. I think that really fit the theme.
The costuming was interesting, in my opinion, just because it went from each holiday. And I was like, doing a costume change in a show choir show is very hard to do because you have like 20 people.
I was going to say, I don't know how you all do it.
Changing off in, on the side of the stage, like on the wings. And it's like, how are we going to do this in the 16 counts we have to change? But they did it very well. Yeah. So
it's weird.
I know you gave them a 10 on everything. So that choreography, very different, huh?
Yes.
Very different.
Yeah, they were all into it. I mean, to an extent, I kind of have a little bit of experience. Like, I can kind of relate it because both of my sisters are cheerleaders. So they kind of, like, competitively. So it kind of reminded me, the choreography kind of reminded me of that in an aspect. Like, in a far-off strand.
I could see that, definitely.
It kind of reminded me of that. So...
Okay, so we'll go into the last category, the overall presentation. This is like general effect for marching band, like Bands of America and Drum Corps International. So, personally, I thought the background could have been, like the background music, like the band could have been a little better. I took 2 points off in that, like in those three sections there. But I liked the pace of the show design. I liked everything about that. Gave them straight tens in those four categories. Just, I had a lot of chills go down my spine through the show, and I was like, woo! Okay, they got it. They got it. So, how do you think about their overall general effect or presentation?
The lead compliment, I think, was perfect. I think I'm spot on. And, you know, this is just being an experienced judge that I am. I feel like it was pretty well done. I think the balance was really well done. I feel like they definitely featured the band when they... I feel like they featured both the choir and the band at separate times, so I think they did it really well cohesively.
Mm-hmm.
Incorporation of band show, nothing to say bad about. I really enjoyed that. Pace of show, I liked it. Show design, you know, it wasn't my favorite, but I still gave him a 10 because, you know, that was, I mean, it was cool. It seems cool. Conception/innovation. See, I feel like, and this is not a knock on them at all, they were a great group. And the show was really cool. It just seems like, I don't know, that kind of, like, a holiday-themed show just kind of seems to me like it seems more often, like, used more often than not. But it was still great, and I still gave him a 9 out of 10. And total effect of the show, I gave him a 10. I did say one thing, though. When they played America, when they had America for the 4th of July, and you know exactly what I'm getting at. When the flag was back there, I'm like, oh, well, this is giving me throwback vibes right here. I like it.
I did say in my head, I was like, oh, Broken Arrow.
It's on tape, homie.
I was so happy. I was like, oh, look at this. Reminds me so much of United States of America. So...
The United States of America.
Okay, well, we'll move on to the questions, and then we'll move on to the next group that Mitchell will end up introducing. So, we talked about how that was for you. Rookie judge, you know, for a show choir. I think you did really well, and I think the CEO will be really happy with that. We talked about the staging and props. We talked about that, and, you know, I think we... Go for that last question that he wants us to ask. You go ask that. That's the only thing we really need to ask here.
What do you want to hear from this group as an experienced vocalist?
Well, this group was very, like, well done, and I think they executed the show well, and I overall said it was great. And I would say that the one that just, yeah, overall they did very well. I think that they executed the show great and they sounded amazing. And as an experienced vocalist, if I was to be in that any other group, I would want to be in one of those groups. Like Brandon, Brio, a great group to be in.
Awesome. How many risers do you guys use compared to other groups? I'm just curious because I know the Tarpon, the conservatory, is a little bit of a smaller
Yeah, we were supposed to have a 32 person show choir this last year, but we ended up having 24.
Oh, wow. We so dropped, that's a quarter of your group.
Yeah, we dropped a quarter of our group this last year. We always use three risers, like three sets of risers, and a lot of bigger groups use four because they're bigger groups, and there's a rare occasion where there could be a fifth. But we won't get into that because that's ridiculous. But, yeah, we use three, so that's sort of what we usually use, and I think this group used four, I'm pretty sure.
Okay.
Okay, well, I'm going to let you introduce this next group now.
All right, so what we have today is Cedar Rapids Happiness Incorporated. So I think this is 2020. It's either 2020 or 2019. And then with
it's something. Show choir years are weird. So 2019 or 2020, whatever it is, it's just it's a very weird.
Oh, winter guard.
Yeah, it's in the part of the year that's very hard to just say because they do it for 2 years. Like marching band, you usually do it just 1 year. But show choir, you start in 1 year and you finish in the next. So it's a little tricky. But so I have one question for you. What do you want to hear from these vocalists and these musicians in the back? What do you want to hear from them?
I personally have never heard them before, so I don't really have any. I don't really have that high of expectations. I think that, again, I think confidence is. And that's not a knock on them. I'm just saying because I don't have the experience of judging like multiple show choirs ever before. That was my first one. So I'm kind of looking to see again the whole thing, the idea with confidence. And I'm going to go back to what we said about serving the music. I think that all groups really should make the most. And I think that they should, again, you know, make sure that they have a presence about them and make sure that they do the music justice, do the background track justice. I'm looking to see them feature a little bit of the show band every once in a while, but obviously this is main attention is on the show choir itself, on the vocals. But I'm looking, it would make me, the band nerd's heart, it would make my heart happy if they featured the show band every once in a while.
You know, every once in a while they have a mellophone in there.
Get out!
I'm not kidding. Every once in a while, there's some show choir groups that use mellophones.
That's one. Great. I love it.
I saw one with a sousaphone, so that's interesting. It's very
even
funny.
Better.
You just see a giant bell in the back, and I'm like, that's hilarious. Okay.
Incorporation of the arts, I'm telling you.
So. We'll probably talk more about the other two questions, or no. So you have that middle question there. Well, let's do that question afterward. But I want you to ask that bottom one, just because the CEO always has us ask questions. So let's talk about that last question before we leave calls.
What do you want to hear from this group as an experienced vocalist?
Well, personally, I've heard this group before, so I really do want to hear just an overall blend of the sound and great presentation from their voices and energy in their sound. It's like a drum corps. You gotta push the energy, you gotta push the belly, and you gotta sing. You gotta use your head voice, and you just gotta get it out there.
There's times where you back off, and there's times where you just go.
Yeah. Okay. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna get into separate calls. We're gonna judge Cedar Rapids now. 2019 or 2020, whatever I think it's probably just 2019 and 2020. Like that's the school year is. I think it's this year, but so yeah, we'll split off. We're gonna do that and then listen on to the tapes. Hello, everybody. I'm Gavin. So this is my tape for Cedar Rapids 2019 or 20. I think it's just that school year. So I think it was this last year. So let me get it full screen here and we'll start. Kennedy Happiness.
It has been honored with numerous Grand Champion, Best Vocals, Best Choreography awards over the years, and has been named America's Favorite Show Choir by Parade Magazine. It was honored by the Iowa State House of Representatives and State Senate after their Grand Champion finish at Show Choir Nationals. This year, Happiness will compete in competitions throughout Iowa and will return to Nashville to compete in Show Choir Nationals. Under the direction,
I like their starting costumes. They look like school uniforms.
Brown and Randy Sage. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Happiness Day.
Cedar rapper, Happiness Kingdom. Great. Like, she reminds me about, like, the Broadway actor for Wednesday for the Addams Family.
Wanna play pretend, wanna ride my bike, wanna hide and seek, do the stuff I like, so many things, and then sometimes I wonder, why do we have to grow up, why can't we stay up forever?
Nice projection, but I feel like it's like sometimes a little too loud. A little too much at times. Nice variety of costumes. When they're in full ensemble with the, all four voice parts, they need more bass and alto. The tenors and the sopranos are demolishing them. I think some of the moves could be a little bit sharper at times, just to give that energy off better, because you guys obviously have a lot of energy. Great use of dynamics. Nice use, guys. Dark sarcasm in the classroom.
bunch of school books. That's a nice use of props.
Some desks? Okay. Stick out. You guys sound beautiful, even though it's very sharp and angry right now. Slamming the desk, that's funny. Transitions are very well done. Nice final pose, very strong. Yeah, get that breath back, guys. You guys are killing it. You sound great, look great, and everything. Oh, the ballad. I wish there was more stuff in the back. Seems very bland. But the props in the front that they've been using for the choreography were used great. Nice job, soloist. Expression and passion for this show. Ah, chills. Woo!
For college.
Day turns to day.
story about growing up. Great. That's a cool costume. Nice job, band. That was a good use of intensity. The show just stops. It's funny.
Watch where you're going.
Sorry.
It's so frustrating.
No one else sees. That was cool. It broke the fourth wall slightly. It was funny. Oh, they changed. Nice. Guys in the back look great too. Usually judges will look at the back rows to see if they're as intense as the front row, because they usually put the front row dancers as like the best dancers in the choir. Everyone looks great. You guys could be a little sharper there. Nice ripple. Not many show cars do a ripple correctly. Or a sequential. Beautiful sopranos. Everyone's doing the kicks, okay. The middle people are. There's heads on the side. Are those seniors? Like, are those people that they know? Those are the seniors of the choir. That'd be pretty cool. Silly pictures, though. Someone has a picture of somebody in like a snorkel mask. Oh yeah, that's them. They're holding themselves. Someone has a chef hat on. That's funny. Someone's painted it just as a clown. Oh, beautiful blend.
Some people didn't fully back off on that forte piano there. Prediction's starting to get a little bit sloppy, but I can still hear it, so I'm not going to take any points off. Another dance break. Oh, they're holding girls up. Great job. Very nice job. And very much enjoyed judging you guys. You guys are a great show choir, just like Brandon Brio. Okay, well, we will hand you off to Mitchell's tape, and we'll get back in the podcast afterward.
All right, and we are back to the judge tape. So I will be judging Cedar Rapids Happiness Incorporated 2019-2020. I'm looking forward to hearing another group and seeing what differences they have from Brandon Brio. Without further, you know what? Let's just get into it.
Honored, been honored with numerous grand champions, best vocals, best choreography awards over the years, has been named America's favorite show choir by Parade Magazine, and was honored by the
interesting little pre-show
and state senate after their grand champion finish at Show Choir National.
I'm curious. I'm curious to see what this choreography is. It's like they have school uniforms. I think this show is about growing up and becoming an adult. I like the accompaniment to the soloist. She's doing really well. I think the entire show choir is in general. Interesting choreography. Nice little dance break, interesting. I think the show band is doing really well. I like how there's multiple soloists. I like how they feature a couple other people, a couple different people. Yeah, the choreography is really cool. They're doing a really good job. They're really expressing it. They're really putting emotion. I can sense the energy from it. So I think that this is definitely a show about coming of age and quote-unquote growing up. I think they're doing it really well so far. I think they're... Huh. I think they're doing a really good job of dynamics, and I really think that, I mean, I like how they throw the band, the show band, in little features, but they're pretty consistent. I like the switch. They switched from the happy and upbeat of childhood, and I think they're now switching to like a now more solemn tone of school.
Revolting children, you are revolting children, and the year revolting times to be.
Interesting. This is an interesting little segment right here. So I think then the rebellion of, you know, rebellion of conformity, that I think that, you know, that makes sense, because I think that's a typical teenage issue. Wanting to go against the flow. So I think that makes sense. I really don't have much to say. I think it was really well done. I think that was a really well done portion. I think this is more of the comparable section to a ballad in a marching show. They went from the high energy to the solemn, like in the first couple minutes of the show, and then to this point, I can definitely tell the energy switched. The tone flipped. Really well done solo. I really like how all the voices are balancing to each other. I think that's one of their strengths as a group. Let's see. Yeah, this is interesting. This is an interesting little show. I feel like it's a little well done. Now it's starting to go into a little bit of a groove. I like the triumph. The calm after the storm. Yeah, I think this is, yeah, I mean. Yeah, this is very expressive, very, very. I mean, very musical. This is very. This is very, lyrical conducted, or it's like calm, collected, and very, again, very expressive. I really like it. Well done. Like little swing, little beat. Let's see, incorporation. Yeah, I really like this part of the show. This is cool. I like how they're featuring more prominently the instrumentalist. And then the choir comes in. I like how the two parts, the male and female lyrics, they conflict with each other, but I think it's a really cool idea of conflicting. And then there's the more uptown, just, you know, kind of faster tempo swing. Well done. I like that how the faces all are depicting different career paths. I think that's really cool and creative. Yeah, I really haven't said much because I really am trying to figure out anything to say negative, because I don't see anything really negative that I can comment on it. I really enjoy this. I think this are really done, and this group is really, really strong. You know, I obviously don't know. I know little to nothing about what a show choir is, other than competition choir and very much, a lot of choreography and music, and as well as with a band accomplished accompaniment. I think this is really well done. And I'm going to be honest, I really wasn't sure of the theme earlier, but I think it's starting to make a lot more sense to me now. I think it's a really cool idea that they're going off of, you know, coming of age and growing up too fast, what they say. I mean, I know I've personally experienced that entire feeling. I'm sure everyone has. Going from, you know, you got your innocent little kid to having to pay bills. And making big life decisions such as, like, university, your occupation, your monetary, your building a house, if you want to build a house, your car. I think this is a really cool little show thing. I think there's a little really cool closer here, too, for this whole thing. I think that this really, really fits it. I like the band, the little trumpet part in the background. Well done. Not over. Well, awesome. That was really cool. I really enjoyed that. I think that was really, really top. I think that was a top group. I think that was awesome. Thank you for performing that, and thank you for letting me have the chance to listen to that for the CEO. I really had a good time with it. So, I'm going to cap this off here, and we are going to head back into the call, and we're going to see what Gavin has to say, too. Thank you.
Welcome back from the judge tapes, everybody. So, we're going to do what we did with Brandon Brio, so we're just going to... I'll say my scores, he'll say his, and then we'll just talk about each section. So, Cedar Rapids. So... I gave you guys an 87 in vocal quality, or just vocal score in total. Like, gave you a 10 in vocal quality. You guys did amazing. That I always rate these top groups with great vocal quality because they know what they're doing. So I'll move on to movement visual. Give you guys a 77 out of 80. Very clean movement. Just some things I noticed, and we'll talk about that with Mitchell. Then overall presentation, I gave you guys a 67 out of 70. So I took 3 points off in each category, so your grand total was 231 out of 240. So Mitchell, you can go on ahead.
All right, so I gave you guys an 89 out of 90 on vocal. My only thing was the balance of parts. I gave everything else a 10, but the balance of parts, I feel like there were a couple times where there's too much soprano, too much. I feel like you guys could balance a little bit more between the four, right? Four soprano, alto, yeah. Tenor, bass.
Then sometimes they have, there we go. Like soprano one and two, but
yeah, I think there was a couple times where you guys could have balanced a little bit better. Visual, I really didn't have any qualms with, so I said 80. I gave a 67 out of 70 on overall presentation because for a little bit the show, like the whole idea behind the show, was a little bit of a question mark for me. It was just like, you know, later on I started clicking and I was like, oh, okay, that makes a lot more sense now that I figured that out, you know. Mm-hmm. But it was still a good show by far. I enjoyed it. It's definitely a different genre of music, and just as a whole, it's a different, like area of music, and it's still really cool though. I really enjoy it.
I
really enjoyed watching.
I agree. It was different to me. Like, but yeah, let's talk about vocals. So yeah, the music wise, it was just very different to me. I judged a lot of groups, like for my teacher, that is just like either 80s, like they do a certain genre of music, and it's like it's sort of the theme of the whole show. And this one like sort of stuck out to me. I was like, oh, so I was confused at first about the theme, just like you were. I was like, okay, I get it. They're school kids, but and like growing up, but what's the costume change? What is that? Because
yeah,
is that them as adults? Because I mean, like, yeah, we can move on to movement as well, because we talked about how like great they sounded, and they used a lot of expression and dynamics in their voices. And then just some points, I agree that
right.
Soprano did stick out, same with tenor sometimes. Just they need some more bass and alto part. They need that lower voice part.
And I mean, going on the costume thing, what I think personally would have been a little bit more like easier to read would be like, all right, so you got your costumes being fine. That's great. But for the ending, I feel like maybe more like a more business attire.
Like a blue collar?
Went home.
Like blue or white collar?
Yeah, like a suit. Like a typical work suit, like what you'd wear if you're going into an office.
I mean, that makes sense in my opinion, because if they're adults, then a lot of adults end up going into businesses that you need to have a tux or like a suit sometimes. So that could have been a better representation of them growing up and being adults.
Right. And I visual I really enjoyed watching. They moved really well. Choreography was really really well done. The physical appearance they brought, they definitely had the composure that I was looking for. The competence, mm-hmm. they just oozed confidence.
I think there's one thing I saw with the group that sort of stuck out to me was sometimes when they got into their blocks, it was a little too close at times, a little. Like, lines weren't centered, and it just bugged me a little bit, because, like, I'm in marching band, and we sort of drill, you know, we drill forms, and then also in show choir at art school, we always want it to be perfect. We want the spacing to be perfect, and we use a number line in front of us that they allow us to have, sort of like our front side line, and it has, like, 0 to 18 and 0 to 18 on the other side, and then you, like, pick your numbers that you're always on.
So, basically, you have dots.
Yeah, we have dots. It's just like a marching band. Just it's a tinier indoor. It's indoor. It's tinier.
Well, I mean, that's interesting. Yeah, I didn't know that. I always wondered, like, one, how do y'all change costumes so darn quick? And then how do you know where to stand? Like, how do they figure that out? How do they do that? Yeah, those are my really two big questions about show choir.
I mean, we barely ever get to change costumes at marching band. It's very rare if you do.
Oh yeah.
But like
costume
changes are easier for show choir, but you have so little time to get it
right.
So it's very stressful.
I will say that. I liked how they had that one vocalist in like the suit, and then the brass, and then the band accompaniment that bought like a lot of time for.
Yeah, like I thought when it just stopped. Because he ran into him. That was hilarious.
Oh, yeah, that was funny. I'm just talking to overall. Is that whole little section
that
gave time for like the choir to recoup and maybe take a little bit of a breather.
Because like back there, they have gone. They have all of their like stuff hung up on this cart, and they all have to find their name, grab it, change, and then run back out.
That's crazy.
And especially when... Like the other show,
never
choir,
be able to do that.
Like Brandon Brio, they did it like 7 times. Like I could not handle the stress of that 7 times. Maybe once, because Tarpon usually sometimes we do it once in our show, but we didn't do it this last year because it was just David and Goliath and we were in silver the whole time. But the year before, they had a costume change, and they had to go off into the wings and they changed as fast as they could.
Right.
So
yeah, that's cruel. That's crazy.
I'm gonna ask you one question, because we've sort of gone over everything already that the CEO wants us to talk about. So let's do one final question. This choreo. All
right.
So we've talked about how all of this relates to marching band and drum corps. I want you to tell me what similarities you see in the choreo that drum corps and marching bands use.
Well, I think for one, the energy. I think the not the choreography itself, but I think the energy behind the choreography. I think the energy has to be the same in whether it's marching band, the show choir, or even like indoor wind or color guard or drum, anything. I think the energy that needs to be used, I think it's the consistent throughout. I think you need to have the amount of energy, I mean, regarding anything. There's definitely a lot more freelance and show choir than marching band. Like, you got your specific counts, and if you don't hit it, you're wrong. am I wrong?
You're not. You're the drill instructor's gonna come and bash a drumstick over your head if you mess up.
Basically, yeah. There have been multiple times where I've gotten a ref stop because of me in person, just me personally messing something up. Like, I kid you not.
Mitchell.
Yeah, Mitchell Irvin, you are 3 steps off your dot.
No.
Let's see. Where was I going with that? Oh yeah, you know, it has more of a little bit of a fluidity to it. I think in that regard, I think it's different from marching band and drum corps, but I think it's a good difference. I think it's everything. Each one of these arts has their own. They have their ups and they have their positives and they have their negatives. Yeah. Like, they have their things they really excel at, and then they have something that they don't excel at as much as another art.
Yeah, and it's all different. Like, a dancer, we don't do everything. We don't do everything a dancer does. Like, you see the color guard doing flips or like handstands. Oh. We don't do that.
Not me.
No.
My back would snap. Like, I would probably hurt myself really badly.
The most free form I've ever had is in RP1 when I got to fight Zach. That's the only thing I've gotten to do is get thrown by somebody. That's it.
Free form for me? The most I've had was this year in our closer where they said just hit these counts and do whatever with your body. that's basically what they said. But we can discuss that if we cover Cardinal 2019 at some point.
We probably will. We probably will.
Somewhat. Fingers crossed.
Eventually. Well.
I think, again, it goes back to the idea of, you know, you got your things that show choir does really well, or like show choir is based on. And I think you got your things that drum corps still does, but not as prominently.
That's a great response. I actually was thinking that you were going to have a different response. Like, they're completely different. Like, it's nothing similar. And I was like, yeah, there's similarities, but I liked your response. It was very in-depth.
Awesome.
Okay, well, we'll call it here. So, next week, we have some extra helping hands coming along. And the podcast next week will probably be a lot longer, because we're going to have quite a... We had news the day we're recording this, yesterday, on Sit Down Wednesday when we recorded it. We were given news that we have 3 more judges. So you're getting introduced to them the Sunday after this week, and they'll be judging throughout the next podcast weeks. They'll be our other hosts, so you won't have to hear our voices all the time. There will be some more variety.
Yeah, you won't have to hear our boring mellophone player voices.
We got a flute player, and 2 percussionists, correct?
Yes, we have a drum line and we have a front ensemble.
That's perfect. We got a woodwind and 2 of each, or 1 of each.
Do we really need a woodwind?
Oh, okay.
Do we really?
I'm going to send...
I'm
going to personally send him the link after the CEO sends it to me to show him what you said today.
I'm just playing, homie.
So, there's going to be a little change. So, the podcast next week will be longer because we've already made our schedule to do 2 groups. After the first week of the new hosts, we're all going to be doing 1. We're only going to be doing 1 show, so it's, like, uniform, and it's not going to be a 4-hour podcast. So, we'll probably be doing 1 show after next week. We'll still be doing these next 2 shows next week, Hurricane Red Hot Show Choir and Marysville Show Choir. We'll be doing that next week, but then after that, we'll be doing one. So, making it easier.
Awesome.
Okay, well, we're going to call the podcast here. Great talking to everyone. This was Gavin Ray.
And Mitchell Urban.
We will see you tomorrow for DCI Friday.